we are going to start the chemical kinetics. So first of all, we should know what is the chemical kinetics. So chemicals means the chemical reaction. It is made by the two words, chemical and kinetics. So what is the chemical? It means chemical reaction. Or kinetics means rate. So first of all, we should know what is the chemical kinetics, the branch of chemistry which deals with three things: rate of reaction, then the factors which affect the rate of reaction, and third one is mechanism. So the branch of chemistry which deals with rate of reactions, factors and the mechanism is called chemical kinetics. So we will study about the what is rate of reaction. So what is the rate of reaction? Suppose A change into product. At starting, the concentration of A is 100% and the concentration of product is 0%. As the time goes, then the concentration of A is decreases and the concentration of product will increase. If we plot a curve between concentration and time for the reactant and for the product, because it is here is the zero, suppose here is the 100% is there. If we plot a curve for the reactant, then at starting when the time is zero, it is maximum. Then after some time it is decreases. And if we plot the curve for the product, at starting it is zero, then it will increase. It will increases with the time. So what is the rate of reaction? Rate of reaction is the change in concentration of reactant or product with per unit time. So what is the rate of reaction? Rate of reaction is the change in concentration of reactant or product with per unit time. So what is the rate of reaction? Change in concentration of reactant or product per unit time. So we can write the rate of reaction is equal to change in concentration of reactant or product upon time taken. We know that the concentration of reactant is decreases, so we put the negative sign, and the concentration of product is increases, so we put the positive sign. So we can also write like this one also, that if suppose A is or R is change into P, R is the reactant and P is the product. So we can write the rate of reaction. How we can write? Rate of reaction is equal to change in concentration of R. Change, we write the change, that is by the delta sign or by the D. If the large change is there, so then we use the sign delta. If small change is there, then we use the sign D. So minus delta R upon delta T, because it is decreasing, the concentration of reactant is decreasing, so we put the negative sign, or for the product it will be positive, delta P upon delta T. Now what is the delta R? Delta R, suppose at the time T1, if the concentration of the reactant is R1, at the time T2, if the concentration of reactant is R2, likewise at the time T1, the concentration of product is P1, at the time T2, the concentration of product is P2. So what is the delta R? Delta R is the R2 minus R1, or delta P is P2 minus P1, or delta T is T2 minus T1. Okay, I am taking the simple example and we will write the rate of reaction. Now I am taking a simple example, that is, suppose it is given to you PCl5 will change into PCl3 plus Cl2, and we have to write the rate of reaction. So now what will be the rate of reaction? Rate of reaction equal to, it is the reactant, these two are the product. So change in concentration, because it is a reactant, so we put the negative sign. You have to remember, and delta, and the what is PCl5 upon delta T is equal, it is the product, we put the sign positive, delta is the change in concentration, that is PCl3 upon delta T. Or equal to, if we put the, again we put the positive sign, so it will be delta concentration of Cl2 upon delta T. I am taking the another example. Suppose this one is given A plus B change into C plus D. Suppose it is given to you and we have to write the rate of reaction. So what will be the rate of reaction? Because these two are the reactants and these two are the product. So rate of reaction, what will be the rate of reaction? Will equal to, these are the reactant, it means minus delta, what is concentration of A upon delta T, or minus delta B upon delta T, or these two are the product, so we put the positive sign. So it will be positive delta concentration of C, change in concentration of C upon delta T, or positive delta concentration of D upon delta T. So we can write like this one. Now if the number of moles of the reactant and products are different, okay, then how we can write the rate of reaction? Because it is very important. I am taking a simple example. This example is, suppose this example is given, N2 plus 3S2 will change into 2 mole of NS3. If the number of moles of reactants and products are different, because it is very important, because the numericals are based upon these types of equations. So you have to remember, because we can calculate the rate of reaction only on the basis of change in concentration, either the reactant or either the product. So we have to write the rate of reaction for one mole. Only we have to write the rate of reaction on the basis of one mole. Here is the 3 mole, then we have to make it 1 mole by dividing by 3. Suppose I have to write the rate of reaction. The rate of reaction will equal to, because here is only 1 mole, so we put the minus delta N2 upon delta T will equal, here is the 3 mole, then we have to write for 1 mole. How we can make it 1 mole, 3 mole? Then by dividing the 3, or by writing the 3 in denominator. So here will be, because it is the reactant, so we put the negative sign, and negative 1 by 3 delta H2 upon delta T, or it will be positive because it is the product. Here is the 2 mole is there. Then for 1 mole means we will write the number of moles in denominator. You have to remember it. And delta NH3 upon delta T. Whatever the equation is given to you, suppose this one is given 2A plus 3B change into 2C plus 4D, whatever the equation is given to you, and we have to write the equation rate of reaction. We have to rate of reaction, so it will be negative, because these are the reactants, the concentration is decreasing with the time, these are the product, concentration is increasing with time. So when the concentration is decreasing, we have to put the negative sign. If the concentration is increasing, we have to put the positive sign. So negative 1 by 2, because here is the 2 mole is there, so we have to make it 1 mole. How it will be make 1 mole? If we write the 2 mole into, here the 2 mole is there, so it becomes 1 mole. So number of moles are written in denominator. So what will be delta A upon delta C T? So it will be negative 1 by 3 delta B upon delta T. Okay, and here is the 2 mole is there, because it is the product, so we will put the positive sign. 1 by 2 delta C upon delta T or positive 1 by 4 delta D upon delta T. Negative and positive sign, it only tells that the concentration, negative sign itself only tells that the concentration is decreasing with the time, and positive sign it tells only that the concentration is increasing with the time. Okay, so they tell only these two things is there. Next one is the numericals, which comes on the basis of these types of reactions. Suppose a equation is given to you. I am taking a question that for the reaction a question is given that for a reaction, this is the question is given for a reaction the reaction is given 4NH3 plus 5O2 will change into 4NO plus 6H2O. Okay, and if rate of formation of NO is 3.6 into 10 to the power minus 3 mole per liter per second, it is given, then calculate the first question, rate of formation of H2O. The second question, rate of disappearance of NH3. Okay, this question is given and we have to calculate. So first of all, while solving this question, first of all we have to write the rate of reaction for 1 mole. Okay, because here the number of moles are different, so we can write this equation, rate of reaction, suppose will equal to, here is the 4 moles, so we put the negative sign because it is reactant. So 1 by 4 change to delta NH3 upon delta T will equal to negative sign. How many moles is there? 5 mole is there, so we will write 1 by 5 delta O2 upon delta T, or here is also positive sign because it is product, the concentration is increasing. So 1 by 4 delta NO upon delta T or positive sign, 1 by 6 delta S2O upon delta T. Now what is given? The given is there, the rate of formation. Rate of formation means what is given? Delta NO upon delta T is given, that is 3.6 into 10 to the power minus 3. It is given. So it is given to us. Now we have to calculate the rate of formation of water. We have to calculate rate of formation of water with the help of this one. So we will take these two equations. Okay, by taking these two equations, we can calculate the rate of formation of water. So what is given? Only takes these two equations. So 1 by 4 positive, 1 by 4 delta NO upon delta T is equal to positive 1 by 6 delta S2O by delta T. So it is given to you. This one is given. So write down. So write down 1 by 4 into 3.6 into 10 to the power minus 3 and equal to 1 by 6 and delta S2O upon delta T. So we have to calculate the value of delta S2O upon delta T. So 6 will come in this side, 6 by 4 into 3.6 into 10 to the power minus 3, and the equation will come, the answer will come, delta T is equal to solve it and we will get the answer. This is the answer is how by this method we can calculate the answer. The second one is given. Secondly, we have to calculate the rate of disappearance of NH3. So we have to calculate it. So this equation is given with the help of these two equations, with the help of 1 by 4 delta NS3 upon delta T, and with the help of plus 1 by 4 delta N upon delta T, with the help of these two equations we can calculate the value of rate of disappearance of NS3. So write down 1 by 4 delta NS3 upon delta T is equal to positive 1 by 4 delta NO upon delta T. This one is given to us. Then write this value, 1 by 4 will cancel. Either it is given, then we have to calculate delta NS3 upon delta T. So 1 by 4 will goes in this side, the 4 by 4 delta NO upon delta T, 4 will cancel out. So this value is given, that is 3.6 into 10 to the power minus 3. So by using these two equations we can calculate the value of rate of formation or rate of disappearance of ammonia. Next, our topic, very important topic, is there factors which affect the rate of reaction. So these are the certain factors there which affect the rate of reaction. First is the concentration of reactant. Second one is the structure of reactants and products. Third one is the catalyst. Fourth one is the surface area. Surface area of reactant. Fifth one is light. And sixth one is the temperature. And last one, seventh one, is the pressure. So these are the certain factor on which rate of reaction depends. First is the concentration of reactant, second is the structure of reactant and product, third one is the catalyst, fourth one is surface area of reactant, fifth one is the light, sixth one is the temperature, and seventh one is the pressure. So we will discuss one by one. First is the concentration of reactant. There was a scientist, Gulbarg and Waage. According to Gulbarg and Waage, he gave a law, that is law of mass action. According to law of mass action, the rate of reaction is directly proportional to the product of molar concentration of reactant. Suppose, and later on we will discuss on it, then firstly the rate of reaction depends upon the molar concentration of reactant. Higher the concentration of the reactant, higher will be rate of reaction. So we can say the rate of reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of reactants. So it is directly proportional. Higher the concentration of reactant, higher will be rate. Second one our is, that is the structure of reactants and products. Because we know that during a reaction some bonds are broken, because in the case of reactant, bonds are broken, and in the case of product, new bonds are formed. If less energy is required for the breaking of bonds and more energy is released during the formation of bond, so the rate of reaction will be high, because in the structure we know that some bonds are bound. During the reaction some bonds are broken and some new bonds are formed I am taking the simple example like this one, 2NO plus O2 will change into 2NO2, then aapka 2CO plus O2 will change into COO2. This reaction is a fast reaction and this reaction is a slow reaction. This reaction is fast reaction and this one is the slow reaction, because there is a double bond between N and O and there is triple bond between C and O, because more energy is required in the case of CO, so the reaction will be slow. Less energy is required in the case of NO, so it will be fast. Simply we can say, if the simple reactants are there, then the rate will be high. If the complex reactants are there, then the rate will be slow. You have to remember this one. Next hour is, that is very important, that is the catalyst. That is catalyst. What is the catalyst? All the teachers are catalyst. How the teachers are catalyst? Because they increase your learning capacity. So what is the catalyst? Simply you have to remember, catalyst increase the rate of reaction. So first you have to remember, catalyst increase the rate of reaction. How they increase the rate of reaction? They do the two things. Firstly, they decrease the activation energy. How they increase the rate of reaction? By decreasing activation energy and by providing alternative path. Okay, the reactants increase the rate of reaction by decreasing the activation energy and by providing alternative path, they increase the rate of reaction. Now, what is the activation energy? We should know what is the activation energy. I am taking a simple example, a simple graph. Suppose this one is graph is given to you. Here is the reactant and here is the product. Okay, then the minimum energy required, because to change the reactant into the product, this amount of energy is required. If the reactant have the this amount of energy, then it will convert into the product. So this energy is known as threshold energy. This energy is known as threshold energy. Every reacting molecule possesses a certain amount of energy that is known as average kinetic energy. Okay, so if the reactants have this amount of energy, it will not convert into the product. So the extra energy, this amount of energy is required. So what is the activation energy? Activation energy is the minimum extra energy. This is known as activation energy. So what is the activation energy? Activation energy is the minimum extra energy required to the reactant to convert into product. Okay, minimum energy required, that is known as threshold energy. Suppose you are in the 12th class, just to pass the 12th class, you required how many percentage? You required the 33% marks. If you will get the 33% marks, then you will go into the next class. That is 33% is known as threshold energy. Okay, threshold energy. So this is the effect of catalyst. Okay, next we will discuss in the next video.